गुड आफ्टरनून
मैम,
मॉर्निंग. वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द लास्ट टॉपिक इज व्हाट आर द कॉसेस ऑफ पॉवर्टी, राइट? यू सेड अ लॉट ऑफ पॉइंट्स एंड वी कैन ऐड सम मोर पॉइंट्स टू दैट. Okay. Children, turn on the videos. Okay, so what are the major causes of poverty? The first is colonial exploitation. Colonial exploitation. What do you mean by colonial exploitation? Please don't write. I will give you time. First, listen here. First, listen here, don't right now. What do you mean by colonial exploitation? Last year you studied about colonial. The term colonization means what? What do you mean by colonial? Children, last year in history you studied about colonization. 8th standard, first chapter. What do you mean by colonial?
When a country.
Right. When a country. Louder, dear.
They fight and they capture another country.
A country is under another country. That is colonization. Okay. The subjugation of one country leads to some changes in
their economy.
Another country. Yes, Elsa and Sriram only remembering that. That is called colonization. Then what do you mean by colonial period? In India, which period is colonial period? Colonial period means at that time, who ruled India?
British.
British. British, right. The British ruled the time. That is called our colonial period. So how the colonial period leads to poverty, or how this colonial exploitation leads to poverty?
The country that which... they capture the country, will take all the resources from the country.
Very good. Very good. Then, for what purpose British came to India?
Trading.
For trade, right? They came to India for trade. And after that, what they did? They captured the power from India. And what is their aim? Is the welfare of the people who are living in India?
No.
No. You heard about industrialization? Industrialization. Industrial revolution in Britain?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? I will not ask what is it. Just ask whether you heard about it.
Yes,
Industrial Revolution. Yes, okay. So after the Industrial Revolution, the British, they began to produce so many goods. Okay. They produce so many final goods and they need a market for their product. And also they need raw materials for their product. The two things they need. One is raw materials and the other is market for their product. So what they did in the countries like India, they converted the countries like their colonies as the market for their product and also as a source for their raw materials. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Till that time, in Indian villages are self-sufficient. Indian villages are self-sufficient at that time. That means they are producing whatever things they need. In a village itself, they will produce all the commodities they need. But when after the advent of British and all, they ruined that. Then the handicraft industry was developed at that time. They ruined the handicraft industry. Agricultural self-sufficiency was there in India. But what the British did is they converted our cropping pattern from food crops to cash crops. Cash crops like indigo. Have you heard about indigo?
Yes, ma'am.
I think 8th standard you studied about it. The indigo, they began to force the people to cultivate such type of goods instead of paddy, wheat and all. So some places in the country, at that time itself, the colonial period itself, our country faced famine and all. Okay, that is one of the reasons for poverty in India. So the first reason is colonial exploitation. Even now when we are analyzing the causes of poverty, we are considering this as an important factor. First is colonial exploitation. Colonial exploitation. That is the policies of the British government in India leads to decline in Indian handicraft and economic growth rate was very low under British rule. No need for studying it in detail. The reason, just know what is one of the cause. Because they ruined the Indian handicraft, they ruined the Indian agriculture and everything. And also the growth rate of India was very low under British rule. It was 1%, 2%, 4%. That was the growth rate of India at the British rule. That's one of the most important reasons for poverty. So what are the causes of poverty? The first point is colonial exploitation. Colonial exploitation means the policies of the British government ruined the India. The economic growth was very low in India at the time of British. That is one of the important reasons for poverty in India. Then the second one is rapid growth of population. How population growth leads to poverty?
When the population increases, the people, we cannot, the demand for the food materials increases, so the rate will also increase.
Yes, right. When the population is increasing faster than the economic growth, what is happening? We don't have sufficient resources to meet the expenses. Correct answer. That is the rapid population growth. See, our country's growth rate is only 2%, but the population growth rate is 4%. That means population is increasing more than the economic growth. In your class also, suppose only 30 benches and chairs are there in the class. If 50 members are there, what will happen? Is it possible to sit all?
No.
Is it possible?
No, ma'am.
No. So what will do the others? 20 extra. What will happen to them?
We will share.
We will share. And if again 20 more come, what to do?
And they will stand there.
They will stand there. Yes, that is the same case if the population is increasing also, right? The resources are less for us. So, and the growth rate is also less, but the population is increasing. Up to a limit we can control, but it is increasing more than that. It is not under the control. So, there is not enough resources for all the people to feed. So, many of the people are living in poverty. So, another important reason for poverty is rapid growth of population. The population growth rate is more than 2% per annum. That means population is increasing and it leads to poverty, not only to poverty and unemployment. See, if there is, you said in the morning, unemployment is a reason for poverty, right? Because if the people have no job, means they have no income. They have no income, they are not able to buy enough food materials for them. It will lead to poverty. So the first reason is colonial exploitation. That means under British period, the growth rate was very less in India and they ruined the Indian industries also. That leads to poverty. Second reason is population growth. When the population is increasing, it is not enough. The resources are not enough for the entire population and the economic growth is less and population is more. The country is not able to feed all the population. So what will happen? Finally, it will lead to unemployment and poverty. The other one is drawback of green revolution. Morning also, I asked you what do you mean by green revolution. What do you mean by green revolution? Green revolution. Which field green revolution is related to which field?
Agricultural.
Yes, agricultural field. By using which type of seeds?
HYV.
HYV. What do you mean by HYV?
High yield.
Yes. Okay. High yielding variety seeds. By using high yielding variety seeds, we began to started cultivating. That is, the Green Revolution was introduced in India around 1966. And the last class we studied about the poverty disparities among the Indian states, right? And there we studied, because of Green Revolution, the agricultural development was more in which of the states? Which are the two richest states in India?
Punjab and Haryana.
So the Green Revolution was effective in only two states, which are they?
Haryana.
Punjab and Haryana. That states, they got the most important. They developed highly. Their production increased. Their income increased. But what happened to the other states like Bihar, Orissa and all? It didn't focus such areas. Okay. So even though Green Revolution was introduced for the agricultural development, but there is regional disparities are there. It widened the regional disparities. Some places, the people benefited more because of Green Revolution, but some places at the same time, the people didn't get any gain because of Green Revolution. So that is another important reason, that is the drawback of Green Revolution. It is limited to a few states and also to few crops. It's due to Green Revolution, the production of wheat and rice increased. Even though we are saying it is for agricultural revolution, but it is not only for all the agricultural product. Because of Green Revolution, the production of only two crops increased. One is rice and the other is wheat. But even though only for few crops, but it doesn't take place all the states in the same time. Oh, it the because of green revolution, some of the states they flourished well, like Punjab, Haryana and all, but some of the states like Bihar, Orissa and all are standing backward. Clear, children? The three reasons are clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Any doubt? See, if you know the explanation, then no need to buy-hurt it. Colonial exploitation. Colonial exploitation means which period? Under British period, the Indian economic growth was very low. And also, their rule leads to the decline in the Indian industries and agricultural sector. Second reason is rapid growth of population. The population growth in India is greater than the economic growth. So it leads to poverty and unemployment. Then another is drawback of green revolution. This green revolution was limited to a few states and a few crops. Especially the green revolution was benefited to some of the states like Haryana and Punjab, and it didn't take place in many of the Indian states like Bihar, Orissa, etc. So they are lacking behind. That they are the poorest states in India. So they lag behind, and some of the states they flourished. It helped to widen the interstate disparities. Next reason is economic inequality. Economic inequality. Who is the richest person in India?
Ambani.
Right? But when we are, when we are calculating the income of the country, how we are calculating the income of the country? Anyone know?
Tax and all know.
Income. In your family, how you are calculating the income?
Salary of all the people.
Salary of all the people working there, right? Only your father's income will consider?
No, mother's.
Mother's also. If the both are working, their income. So income means all income we are considering. Same way for a country also, how we are calculating its income?
Income of all the people in the
country. Income of all the people in the country we are considering. It include my income, Ambani's income. Is it same? Sriram is laughing. Is it same, dear?
No.
No,
that you know that it is not same. But when we are calculating the income, it includes his income and our income. So when his income is increasing, what happened to the total income?
It will also increase.
It will also increase, right? My income is decreasing and Ambani's income is increasing. What will happen to the national income?
Nothing will happen.
Nothing will happen, right? It will increase. But in return, it may be affect, right? His income is decreasing and our income is increasing. It will affect. Same way, there is income inequalities there. The richer people. So most of the resources are in the hand of the rich people. Income inequality. Income is not equally distributed among the people. The richer become again richer and richer, and the poorer become again poorer and poorer. That is also a reason for increasing poverty. Another cause is economic inequality. That is, most of the resources of India are owned by a small group of rich people. Ambani, I said an example, not only Ambani is there, Mukesh Ambani is there, Anil Ambani is there, then another Adani group is there. So many are there, okay? So many rich people. But they may be 10 or 12 persons, maximum 15 persons may be the richest person in India. And they possess around 80% of our wealth. So that is the economic inequality. Most of the resources of India are owned by a small group of rich people. And inequality between the rich and poor is one of the main causes of poverty. This income inequality. The richer people are again richer and richer, and poorer people's income is again decreasing. Then indebtedness. That is debt trap. The people have taken loan from money lenders for unproductive purposes. This point morning we discussed. You remember that if you're working in Gulf and if you're constructing a house, Is it a productive purpose or unproductive purpose?
Unproductive.
Always remember, when we are constructing a big house or when we are buying a luxurious car for our personal use, all these are unproductive because of that there is no income is generating in the economy. But instead of that, if you are starting a business, it is coming as a productive purpose. So the people are taking loans for unproductive purposes, and if they are not able to repay the loan, it will lead to debt trap. Most of the poor people are taking loans for unproductive purposes, and it leads to debt trap. Morning we discussed this theme. Remember, children, it will lead to debt trap. Once they are there, they are not able to come out of this, because one loan is there, they are not able to repay it. So what they will do? Maybe they will take another loan to repay that, then again another. So always they will be in that trap. Once they are caught in the trap, they are not able to come out of it. That is debt trap. These are the major causes of poverty. So for the exam, this may be a question: what are the major causes of poverty? One is colonial exploitation. Colonial exploitation means the policies of the British government leads to the decline of Indian it declined the self-sufficiency of Indian villages, and also the economic growth rate was very less. So it leads to poverty in India. Then rapid growth of population. The population increased faster than the economic growth. Third one, the drawback of Green Revolution. The Green Revolution was limited to only few states and for few crops, and many of the places they didn't get the benefit of Green Revolution, especially the states like Bihar and Orissa. Now also they are the poorest states in India. Then economic inequality. Most of the resources of India are owned by a small group of rich people, and the income inequality widens the gap between the rich and poor, and it is also an important reason for poverty. Then indebtedness. That means the people are taking loan for unproductive purposes, especially in the rural area, and all the people are taking money. They are taking loan from whom in rural areas? Even now, louder.
From money lenders.
Even now in the some of the villages, a bank, they don't know about the bank facilities. That's why we introduced this. Have you heard about Jan Dhan accounts? Jan Dhan Yojana.
That Prime Minister's.
Yes. It is for zero balance accounts were started for the people, without so much securities or not much procedures. Have you heard about it, Jan Dhan account? You heard about the demonetization? 2016, two notes were banned. Do you know that?
500 and 1,000.
500 and 1,000. So how the people converted this money? Those who have 500 and 1,000.
The bank.
And if the people have no bank account, what they did? Before that, almost all the people in India have that Jan Dhan account. Okay, by using their account, they transfer. Even though for the poor people, sometimes they don't know the banking procedures and all. That's why they are not able to go to loan. Nowadays, I think every benefit they are getting through the bank, right?
Yes, ma'am.
No idea in your home? How?
By bank.
Through banks, right? But in many of the states, the people don't know about the bank. And even now, they are depending on whom for money? Money lenders. And they charge different interest. They are taking loan maybe for unproductive purposes, maybe for their health care or for the marriage of their children or something. They are taking money from that. If there is a crop failure or something, they are not able to repay the loan. So if they are not to repay the loan, again, if they need money, again, they depend on them. they will buy money from them, that is increasing. So they will be finally in a debt trap. Finally, they are not able to repay the money and they will be in debt trap. So these are the major causes of poverty. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Any point want to explain? Colonial exploitation, rapid growth of population, drawbacks of green revolution, economic inequality and indebtedness. These are the major causes of poverty. This may be a question for the exam. What are the causes of poverty? Then, so poverty is there and ours is a democratic form of government and the government play an important role in reducing poverty. What government can do to reduce poverty? You heard about any poverty alleviation programs? You heard about any program? Louder. Louder. If it is wrong, we can correct it. Don't worry.
The chief minister told that he will generate more employment.
Ah, very good. Creating more employment opportunities is a way to solve poverty. Then, for increasing more employment opportunities, what the government is doing? You heard about? Louder, Anandu.
They form new industries.
They can start new industries. Okay. Then, think for increasing more employment. Poverty can be solved by increasing more employment opportunities, right? That is a permanent solution for poverty. Then how we can increase employment opportunities? One is, as Anandu said, if we are starting more industries, automatically it will create more employment opportunities and all. The another method is like creating more employment opportunities itself. How? Children, have you heard about Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Program? No. Have you heard about Thozhilurappu Paddhathi?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Anyone? The yes, same ma'am. Thing is MNREGA, okay? Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. That is called as, in Malayalam we are saying, Thozhilurappu Paddhathi. Same thing. By that, the government is providing more employment opportunity. So like that, the government introduced so many programs. Okay, that is only one program. So many programs. Pradhan Mantri, Swarna Jayanti, Rozgar Yojana. Then, louder.
Food stamps.
Not clear.
Food stamps.
Food for work programs. Some programs are its own name, okay? That we cannot change. Food for work program. Then rural employment guarantees program. So many food stamps. Okay. Is that a program? So many programs were introduced by the government for reducing poverty. Okay. So many programs were introduced by government for reducing poverty. That we can discuss in the next class. Today is, I hope it's clear to you what are the causes of poverty and how we can income support. Poverty alleviation programs. It have its own name, like MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. That is, in Malayalam, we are saying Thozhilurappu Paddhathi. Same thing. That is for creating 100 days of employment among the people. Like that, so many programs are there introduced by the government. Okay. That we can discuss in the next class. Okay then. Thank you all. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.